Today we will discuss about Indian schools of philosophy. Basically, there are two portions, one Nastic and Astic. Astic is called heterodox and Nastic is called orthodox. Astic people believe in Vedas and Nastic people don't believe in Vedas. That's a basic difference.
Astic, which is orthodox, which accepts Vedic concepts and authority. Second one is the Nastic, which is heterodox, which is Charvaka, Buddha, Jain followed, which is not accepting the Veda. Veda is not their authority. Regarding the orthodox, for which the Veda is the authority, there are, based on the Vedic teaching, schools are divided into two classes. One is Mimamsa and the other one is Vedanta. There are subclasses which independent schools which don't follow specifically the whole Veda as an authority as it is, but with logical reasonings along with the Veda. They are called Sankhya and Yoga philosophy, Nyaya and Vaisheshika. In the Mimamsa, the schools, the emphasis is on the rituals aspect of the Veda. And on the Vedanta, the emphasis on the reflective aspect of the Veda. That is more of logical and knowledge based. The Bharatiya scriptures basically are Vedas, Smritis, Darshana Shastra, Puranas, Itihasas, and Bhagavad Gita is also part of one of the Itihasa, which is Mahabharata, but considered as a very specific status. Therefore, it's another one. In the Vedas, we have Vedangas and Upavedas. And one of the greatest component of Veda is the Upanishads. We know basically the Vedas are Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda. Among which we have got the Darshana Shastra, which we will explain later, little detail. There are writings of the Acharyas and Jagadgurus, which are also in parallel with the Puranas. The writings of the great saints have got an equal status, equivalent to Purana. Bhagavatam is Devi Bhagavatam and Krishna Bhagavatam. Both are part of the Puranas. Itihasas and Puranas are stories wherein the basic concept of Veda is explained clearly. The philosophical schools, if you consider, based on the philosopher and the system and the text, there are 9 major ones. One by Brihaspati, Mahavira, Siddhartha Gautama, Kapila, Patanjali, Kanada and the Gautama, Jaimini, and all these philosophical schools are considered as Bharatiya, Eastern, philosophical, Indian, Hindu philosophies. Major contributions in the thought process of how the sufferings of the people can be nullified. That is what is explained. The seeing is the nature and knowing by the person. So the seeing by the person, knowing by the person about the nature, that how that can simplify the life is what is philosophy or philosophical explanation, or the hunt on this is what is philosophy. So therefore philosophy is called a Darshana Shastra, and in which we have the Astika Darshana, which are Sankhya, Yoga, Nyaya, Vaisheshika, and Purva Mimamsa, Uttara Mimamsa or the Vedanta. The Nastikas are the Buddhist, Jainist and more materialistic type of looking at things. the branches of Vedanta, Dvaita,
the Vishishta Advaita, Advaita.
Tarka Shastra has got a different branch, which is the culture of debate, logically asking questions. The historical outcome of the Advaita Vedanta is what we majorly concentrate in this discussion. Among the Darshana philosophy, we have got Vaisheshika, which is of Kannada, the few atomic building blocks and the consciousness of the scientific logical explanations and the futility of Maya is what is explained there. Nyaya of Gautama is a logical quest for God, phases of creation. Logic and analytical philosophy is what is explained. Yoga, Patanjali explains the meditation and contemplation. The practices of meditation and samadhi for renunciation, self-actualization is what is yoga. Sankhya is more a consciousness and matter-based descriptions which eliminate the physical and the mental pains and receive liberation. That's more of knowledge-based, logical. And Vedanta, which is the essence of the Vedas, Veda Anda, essence of Vedas, explains the divine nature of the soul, Maya and the creation. Veda Vyasa has got the authority on that. Mimamsa is by Jaimini, which explains the Vedas are eternal and divine. The critical interpretation of the Veda is what is done by Jaimini Maharshi in Mimamsa. These are the six classes. Now look at the Nyaya, Sankhya, Mimamsa, Advaita, Vaisheshika and Lokayata. How these are in the perceptions, inference, analogy, derivation, non-perception and testimony. You can see the Advaita carries all these adjectives. Therefore, the Shabda, which is the testimony to the Pratyaksha, which is the perception, the Anumana, which is the inference, the Upamana, which is the analogy between one to another one, the Arthapati, which is the derivation, Anupa Labdhi, which is the non-perception. Everything is part of the Advaita. Therefore, Advaita has got more authority, a philosophical outlook when compared to Mimamsa, Nyaya, Sankhya, Vaisheshika or Lokayata. This is why Advaita has got more acceptance or more divisions or more explanations, more studies by the later part of the people. Understand, the Vedas were written, Upanishads were written, and the Hindu philosophy was accepted by the majority. But this happened probably between the documentation, the text, the religious philosophical nature was explained between 500 to 800, 800 BC to 500 BC. But that's a time when Mahavira and Buddha, mostly contemporary, who came in the 5th century BC with their philosophy and which might have contradicted with the Upanishad concept, and some people transferred their attention from the Upanishads to the Buddha and Jaina philosophies. That is, after that, maybe 100 years from then, the Bhagavad Gita came into picture and the Shankara's Bhashya came further to that, based on the Badarayana's essence of Upanishads written in the form of Brahma Sutra or the Vedanta Sutra, which was followed by Shankara.
Brahma Sutra, which explains the Upanishad essence in a more fundamental method for both spiritual and philosophical concept, which considers as the sharira of the saint and the meditation part of the saint.
It has got 555 verses in 4 chapters, which explains the existence of the universe, the ideas about the metaphysical concept of the ultimate reality called the Brahman, which discusses in the first chapter the metaphysics of the absolute reality. Second chapter explains the reviews and addresses the objections raised by the idea of the competing orthodox schools of Hindu philosophy as well as the heterodox school such as the Buddhism and Jainism. We already explained by this time the Buddhism and Jainism was in practice by majority of the people who were originally part of the Upanishad Veda followers. Therefore, second chapter reviews, compares and give objections on the heterodox part, and the orthodox part of Veda is emphasized here. The epistemology and the path of gaining spirituality and liberating knowledge is what is explained in the third chapter, and fourth chapter explains this importance of the human need for gaining this knowledge and states why such a knowledge is, why such a philosophy is essential for human being. So the fourth one is a justification for bringing up the Brahma Sutra.
There are a lot of people who followed from 8th century to 16th century the commentaries on Brahma Sutra. The major contributions are by Shankara himself. So therefore, the school of thought, the idealistic monism which prescribed by Adi Shankara in the Advaita is very, very important.
The Bhaskara, which has got in the 10th century, and Yadava Prakasha, Ramanuja in the 12th century, the Vishishta Dvaitika, and Vaidvedika, Bhakti movement are the concepts. So each one of them has got a theme and school of thought. The Dvaita, which came in the 13th century by Madhava, Nambraga, Srikanta, Vailabha and Shuka are the people who contributed in terms of the different schools from 13th century to 16th century.
Among which the maximum acceptance in line with Badarayana's Brahma Sutra, which has got a Advaita Siddhanta prescribed in it, was given by Shankara. Rest of the people followed the second and third chapter.
Sub schools of Vedanta are the Advaita Vedanta and Dvaita Vedanta. The Dvaita and Advaita by the Madhava and from Shankara from the 8th century. Neo Vedanta by Vivekananda and Radhakrishna ends up in the 19th century. So, we have Shankara from 8th century to 19th century by Vivekananda and Radhakrishna, which are the major contributions in Indian philosophy. Now, when you look at them very carefully, you see that there are two portions. One is the witnessing person and the root causes for what happens. One is Purusha and the other one is the Prakriti. The consciousness and unmanifested, the prominal matter, the primordial matter, primordial matter, root causes, manifested primordial matter, and the consciousness and the witnessing, which is called Purusha. One is Purusha and the other one is Prakriti. And the Mahat or the Buddhi, the Ahankara concepts, the Prakriti has got the Buddhi and the Ahankara, the root causes. One is the Atma, and the second one is Adi Bhautika. That means it is not from me, but from the nature. The another one is the Adi Devika. One from me, I am the cause. Second one, Adi Bhautika. That is from the external, from the matter, wherever the causes are. In that Prakriti, subdivisions are, one is based on the Devigam part. The Devigam part is not the Prapancham around, not the Indriyas which can understand. He is one portion which is about part of the nature. The second part is the Adi Devigam. Adi Bhautikam and Adi Devikam and Adhyatmikam. The purification of Adhyatmikam doesn't happen. We find reasons for every action based on what is in the Prakriti. Adi Bhautikam and Adi Devikam. Adi is the beginning. The reason for my suffering is explained in terms of what is around me. For example, if I have pain based on my body pain or on the manas pain, I say it is mine. I am the reason for that. But assume that something falls on me, and because of falling something on me, say that when I am climbing somewhere, the ladder has fallen. I may find reason on the ladder which may say that because of the ladder I have fallen down, or because of the vehicle met with an accident I had a problem. So the reason is put to the vehicle but not to me. So that is called Adi Bhautikam. But in Adi Bhautikam, if I am so careful, if I am an expert, I would have safeguarded me. Therefore, there is a philosophy or an argument which says even the Adi Bhautikam is not the real cause for my suffering, but it is on my carelessness. If there is a dog biting me, I would have taken care of in such a way that the dog will not bite me. Therefore, if I am careful, as I am more conscious, I can take care of the Adi Bhautikam portion. Then the concept came Adi Devigam. Say there is a cyclone, say there is an earthquake which is not at all in my control, and there is a limit for my taking care, and such problems created by the Deva, he is the cause for my suffering, and that cannot be explained by my ability to conquer, my ability to be careful, my ability to take care of myself. Such concepts are explained. Therefore, these are the main philosophical concepts. But again, assume that there would have been a board which says, or the season is such which is heavy rain and there is a reason for a flood, or I should not have gone near to the seashore, close to the mountain, so that I could have taken care of my sufferings. So Adi Devigam also can be taken care of by special attention which I should have taken care. So these are the explanations which is given. So there is a Adhyatmika, Adi Devigam, Adi Bhautikam concepts in the philosophical manner. So both have got a Purusha, who is the sufferer, and Prakriti, who is the root cause for my all sufferings, or the root cause for my all blessings and the nature. Therefore, the Purusha-Prakriti relationship is what is explained. When you explain Prakriti, now you will have the sensory organs which conceptualize the all the five elements which are part of the nature, etc., etc., like earth, water, fire, air, space. The grassroot elements also will be explained. The subtle elements will be explained. The active instruments will be explained. The cognitive sense with which I am going to understand these also will be explained. This is how the major Indian philosophy can be introduced. We will have more details on the rest of the subjects, detailed explanations on each of the components in the coming videos. Thank you.